traditionally, in Judaism, at Purim, all girls want to dress up as Esther. But Jewish feminists say, well, wait a minute, she's playing the man's game. Is that really what you want your daughter to do? Or would you like your daughter to be more like Vashti, who says, no, I refuse to do this? Because it's possible, and this is one Jewish traditional reading of Esther, is she is to come wearing her crown, i.e. wearing only her crown, because she is certainly an object. Like, I've shown you all my kingdom, and now here's my wife. And then she dares to say no. And what is he to do, right? She's disobeyed. So how you read chapter one as in an ironic fashion, or as like a spoof on like this king has so many, you know, 127 provinces, and the 180 days of drinking and feasting, and then 7 more days. And then after 7 days of drinking and goblets of wine, I'll show you my beautiful wife. And she says no. So that's a really interesting episode. And people wonder, why would she say no? Did she have leprosy? Was she pregnant? Or had she had enough? And reading that story within the context of the ancient world is, wives were allowed to come to the party, to banquets. But once the drinking got out of hand, the wives went home. You bring in the dancing girls and concubines. So it makes sense to me, as the queen, she said, this is not my role. I will not do this. So Vashti was a person who said, this is far enough. At least this is an ethical issue. And I, in my own life, when I was teaching Vashti and Esther, when my kids were little, my youngest was demanding, I want to sit in the front of the stroller and, you know, temper tantrums and so on. And I would say, the Vashti in me has to say, no, I can't give you your way all the time. Even if it costs me another temper tantrum, no. So Vashti has become an interesting character as a model to say, I won't cross this line. I have, and it's not just it's not a gendered thing. It's just an ethical model. As Joseph said no to Potiphar, so Vashti says no in terms of an ethical decision. That's one way of reading the text, and one I find helpful. So it is an interesting book in that way, in terms of the portrayal of women. The woman who says no, and it costs her everything, and the woman who says yes, and stays in power. So there, it models different ways of living an empire. You can say no, it may cost you everything, or you can work the system and God can use you within that way. And I think both models are there.